Welcome to episode 2 of the Commando Cast. I am Mike.
And I'm Andrew, and today we are doing a deck tech episode. All right, so today we're doing a deck tech episode, and in these episodes, what Mike and I are going to do is we are going to cooperatively build a deck. I'm going to give Mike a pairing, and we're going to work and build it. And then what I'm going to do over the weekend is I'm going to play it at the tournaments I go to over the weekend, record it, and put those videos on the Commando Cast so you guys can follow on both. Or sorry, on the Dice Commando channel so you guys can follow both. In this episode, what we're going to do is we're going to build new Han. I call him Hotshot Han and Yoda, and we're also going to use the new plot, Double Dealing. Double down.
He did it again. That's funny.
So what we're going to do first is we all know that Hotshot Han and Yoda are going to be the characters. We know we're going to use Double Down. And we, of course, are going to use Thief Palace, right? I don't think there's any argument that Thief Palace is going to be the battlefield, right? So we've got all that selected. I think the next step that we want to do is we want to choose what our three ups are going to be.
Yeah, so double down, for those of you who maybe don't know, is a two-cost plot that allows you to add three copies of up to two cards into your deck, which breaks the standard deck-building rule of only two of every card.
Right. So I know what mine's going to be. Okay. The first one I have is the Black Sun Pistol.
Okay, well, let's do it this way. I'm an awful deck builder, so I'm going to give mine, and then you can clean up my trash.
Fair enough.
And then, so don't listen to me, probably listen to Andrew in this part, but my two were Hyperspace Jump.
Mm-hmm.
I come from the school of Yoda Cassian aggro, so Hyperspace Jump, I won my Sword Championship in the Milpocalypse era,
the week after Gen Con.
Right. So Hyperspace Jump was an absolute must in that deck. And then I had three copies of probably my favorite card is Impulsive. It is just such a, it's such a backbreaker. It's a backbreaker and it's flexible. Impulsive allows you to resolve whatever dice with Ambush. It's a very simple card, but it's devastating at the right time.
Now, and I also won my Sir Championship also with Yoda Cassian. Interestingly, it was very early in the meta, so I was playing that mill at the time.
Right.
So Mike and I have a lot of experience with the yellow-blue pairing. But correct me if I'm wrong, you were actually running all-in your Yoda Cassian over the summer, right?
I was.
You were, right?
I was running all-in.
Because you were running the guns. So. Yeah. But I agree, Impulsive. I've run Impulsive for a long time in my Poe yellow deck. It used to be Hondo. Now it's Han as well. So I agree with Impulsive.
Tell me about...
Three of them, though, I don't know. There's a lot of other good three as we can do. I also had Hyperspace Jump. Completely 100% agree with Hyperspace Jump. I think that's the way to go.
All right. So mark
that
down
as a three.
Hyperspace Jump. Okay, good.
Okay.
And what's your three of?
My other three of is the Black Sun Pistol.
And that is the...
So it's a three-cost upgrade. It has redeploy while on a neutral character, right?
Okay.
So we would be dropping this on Han.
Okay.
And it says a two-ranged. I think it has a disrupt... a money, and then it has two specials. The special says deal two indirect damage and then deal one damage to a character.
Correct.
So for Yoda, that's pretty good. You just deal two indirect, you can deal a damage. It's three damage, but the thing I really like about it is the redeploy, right? I could also see an argument for going 3 second chance.
Okay.
But again, I'm pretty open. I know in just brief talking about other decks, I think we're both pretty much in love with N1 Starfighter right now.
Yes.
Do we want to consider three of that one?
So the reason you run three of is twofold. Either it's so impactful that you want to cast it three times, or you need the consistency of making sure that you get it. So let me ask you, on Black Sun Pistol, are you thinking of having a triple-wielding Yoda Black Sun Pistol build, or is this more of you want to get this in your first five
cards? I want to get it in my first five cards.
Okay.
Right, because there's two advantages of having the three drop out is, well, I mean, getting that first turn is really big, because then you can make sure you put it on Han and get a use out of it.
Right.
Right, but the other thing is it gets overwritten if you're in a pinch with second chance.
Right.
And I also am really struggling when I kind of do the quick... notebooking of this, I'm struggling to find a lot of upgrades, and I feel like this deck probably needs to be a little upgrade heavy because you're going to be making money and you want to go fast. yet I can't find the upgrade. So that's kind of why I was going to three of them.
Yeah, I struggled as well. My first 10 upgrades were 10 in my deck. I had two Black Sun pistols.
Yeah, but two of those were probably Force Illusion even, which aren't dice cards, right?
Actually, I don't run Force Illusion.
You don't?
I do, okay. I do not. And I might be crazy, but I like... I'm much more of an aggro-y player with, with the blue-yellow. So
are you running like Holdout and stuff?
Is yeah, so the Ambush Pistols, Second Chance, and I like Force Speed. I don't know if it's necessary, but you know, because we're already going to be so fast. Mm-hmm. But yeah, so Black Sun Pistol for you is a must. The reason you want three is so that you can make sure you get it in your first five.
Correct.
Okay, and how am I going to deploy that first turn quickly?
Feed Palace.
Okay. All right.
So right. Or worst case, I mean, if you don't get your battlefield, then you roll out Yoda and... Okay. Do Yoda things. Great.
I'm completely willing to run three Black Sun Pistols because it is a... In fact, I will say this. It's such a good upgrade on Han. I would be loath to override that with a second chance.
Yeah, I think it's a tough... I think you're not going to always want to... I mean, you're going to save Han.
Right.
Right. You're going to override it if you're in a pinch. I don't think we're going to have money problems with this deck. I don't.
Okay.
Right. I mean, that we're running three hyperspace jumps. You're not running three hyperspace jumps if you think you're going to have problems.
that's fair enough. Okay.
Right. Now, are you proposing? I'm skipping ahead. Are you proposing Maz's Vault?
No.
Because I'm not either.
No. Maz's Vault was really cute until there was people casting four TIE fighters and a right. Vader fist right. for sure.
I don't think we need Maz's Vault also because of Feed Palace.
Yeah. And I think what it does is it gives us a distinct battlefield advantage. Mm-hmm. If we take Feed Palace. That's one of those battlefields that's good for us and only okay for our opponent.
Yeah, I mean, unless they're running neutral, but even so, I think right. we're going to be ahead of them. So, okay. So is that we're going to go with then? We'll go with three Sun Pistols?
Yes, we'll go with three Sun Pistols. I think that's a... I like your reasoning. That's pretty sound.
Okay. And 3X Jump. Okay, so we've got those down. And now let's move into kind of what I would consider to be the staple cards, okay. the cards that Mike and I aren't necessarily going to argue about. The first one that comes to mind, obviously, is Easy Pickings.
Sure.
Right? Yeah. So let's get two Pickings.
Yeah.
Two Impulsive. I mean, we already had that discussion. Right. Two Impulsive need to go in there. That's right. No-brainer. I think this is a no-brainer. Maybe you don't. What do you think about Philp, Friends in Low Places?
I don't necessarily think it's a no-brainer. I don't have it in my initial build. Mm-hmm. I'm trying to think what spot I would put that in. Oh, you know what? I ran three vehicles. Did you run two vehicles?
I'm running two N1s. Are you? You're running the N1 as well?
I'm running two N1s, and I propose a Millennium Falcon from the...
Oh, the Legacy's 4-drop Falcon?
Correct.
I would assume, because that's a pretty good... Right.
And it's gonna help speed us up.
I can actually get on board with that. So again, we're getting out of order.
Right. Sorry.
No, that's fine. But that's fine. So N1 Starfighter, and you know, can you read the N1 Starfighter real quick?
Yeah.
Those? I'll also put it up on the screen. But
yeah, absolutely. So it's a hero rare support, costs three. Its sides are two guns, three indirect, two shields, one resource, one special. Special reads: ready or discard an exhausted vehicle. That is not a copy of this support.
Right. So, all the sides are good. Right. But what's really great about it is that you can special chain into the special, right. which can help at least counter these reset decks, right?
Yeah.
Which are running everywhere.
It doesn't care what size the vehicle is or how many mods it has on it.
Right.
There's a couple of removal cards for vehicles, but a lot of them say, or they let you use your vehicle, but they can't have mods on them.
Right.
They're limited by the cost. This doesn't give a care all at once
yep.
is that
all they gotta exhaust. Do is roll on their Shadowcaster and boom.
Yeah, if right. you have a special on board with this dice in the pool, if you have a Yoda special on board with this dice in the pool, you're effectively telling them you may not use your fat vehicle.
Sure, and you gotta remove it first.
Right.
Yeah. So.
So I love it.
Yeah, in agreement. I'm actually on board. Well, tell you what, I'm on board with the Falcon, the 4-cost Falcon. Let's actually put that in I'll put a star next to it just for accounting.
That's a flex.
To see where we're at, right?
Yeah, that's a flex
as
spot
a flex
for
spot.
Me. Can we talk about the removal suite before we get into the other general events?
Let's do upgrades first.
Oh, upgrades. That's right.
Because if we do... We want to know how many slots we have before we start talking about removal, right?
So we're doing three Black Sun Pistols.
But I don't know that we've completely finished our... Are there any other must-haves, staples that you think have to go in here?
So we have easy pickings.
The one I have is overconfidence.
I have two overconfidences.
Yeah. That's I think that's kind of a no-brainer. And then the last one I have is hidden motive.
Yep.
For obvious,
correct,
amazing reasons, right?
Correct, yeah.
And I think those are what I had considered my staple cards. So there's eight right there that you were concerned about much of being your removal package. I don't know if that's where you were going or not. So
yeah, I only have three more in my removal package that aren't listed. So
okay, so one upgrade that I've found to be pretty good with the Yoda special chaining is Ezra's lightsaber.
Okay,
do you have that?
I don't, because I was going for more of a speed build. So my build was ambush weapons.
So you're playing quick draw as well, then?
I am not playing quick draw. I'm only using it for tempo. We have to be first to the claim, and we have to be able to resolve our dice. So I went with Hidden Blaster and Holdout Blaster just for pure tempo.
Okay. Thinking that with the pistols and the second chances and stuff, we're going to be able to overwrite. Because most of this stuff's going on Han.
Correct.
Right? And if they go for Yoda first, then so be it, and he's loaded.
Yeah, and this gives me the holdout, the hidden holdout give me a target to override that isn't a Black Sun pistol when Han gets low on health.
Okay, so I can get on, So, I mean, the holdout I agree with. I love redeploys. I love value. The hidden is just a good card.
Right.
Does not redeploy. And then, of course, the card we haven't counted yet is second chance, but that's a staple that we're not going to really debate over.
Yeah, that's...
I do think we should run two illusions.
Okay.
It's just too good. I wish you could run like armor plating in here, but you can't.
Yeah, that would be, that'd be pretty good.
All right, what else do you have in terms of upgrades?
But those are, I had four speeds, so that's probably where we're going to have to make it, to disagree.
Yeah, I've never liked four speed in this type of deck, right? But four speed's really good, don't get me wrong. I just, it's never...
It just gets around your opponent's... deal. Removal. Like, I roll out Yoda, he rolls the special, or any special which he's going to. It's like having a quick draw every round for Han.
All right, so what we're going to do, two four speeds, and then when it doesn't work for me, I can blame
you. Yeah, absolutely. Or do it, and then totally blame me. I'm willing to take that.
All the bad plays that I make on stream are Mike's fault. So, okay, that's fine. So let's do a quick cost curve here. So there's a 0, a 1 on the illusion that I'm insisting we have to play it.
Sure, okay.
Right? The second chance is a 3, the sun pistol is a 3, and then a 2 and a 2. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 dice cards, 13 upgrades. That's actually, 13 upgrades is
that's a pretty good,
that's a good number. Especially when we're playing three of the big gun that we want, the sun pistol. So I'm actually okay with that. I know a lot of these type of decks actually play like in the 15 range. They do like a 50-50, especially when you're playing with 4 speed, which is a 0 drop. But we also have the end ones.
Right.
So I don't know. We'll have to see at the end. I don't know that we're going to be able to play Falcon in the four speed.
My only thing with Falcon was Yoda can sometimes struggle to do damage at the end of the game.
Mm-hmm.
If Han goes down, it just gives you another dice that does heavy damage. Like I said, it's a flex spot for me.
Sure. Let's see what we're left with at the end.
Okay.
All right. So just a quick card accounting. We have 13 upgrades.
Okay.
I think we're pretty set on those. We have 3 supports, counting the Falcon, which we'll go ahead and count for now.
Okay.
We have 3 jumps, which will fit into our event suite. And then we have 8 staples, which brings us to 11. So that's 16 and 11. That is 27. So we only have 3 spots to play with. We've actually knocked this down pretty quick.
Yeah.
So what is your... as far as us having extra money at the end, if Yoda's the one left over, I think you want to be playing your bigger removal like Beguiles or
Mind Trick. Yeah,
or Mind Trick.
Yeah, so my build originally had 2 Beguiles and 1 Entangle. I like Beguile because it is not a spot.
It's not a spot. I agree. Right. So I think we can agree Entangle is a one of.
Yes, correct. I think it is a one of.
And Entangle's really good, though.
I had Indifferent, but I don't necessarily think it's... I think I liked it just because it's a Han card.
So here's where I actually went back and forth with this. I actually went back and forth on whether I wanted to run Philp or I wanted to run Indifferent. And I know they have 2 very different purposes, but that's kind of where I was falling on my slot. So I like Indifferent because it removes any die.
Right, it doesn't care.
But you have to have Han alive.
Correct. And being that he is obviously the first target, right? Especially after you rock them first round.
I think most people are going to go for Han first because they're going to be scared of second chance.
Yeah. Well, the first time you power action and take other action, they're going after it. I've actually played quite a bit this week of Vader Jawa, and you would be shocked the number of people that after I power action and take another action, they're just like, you know what? I got 6 damage. I'm going to go ahead and kill a Jawa so that trick goes away. I think it's going to draw a lot of aggro as soon as the first
time. Yeah, I mean, that's fair. I actually don't mind blowing, if I can one-shot it, I don't mind blowing Vader's Spuddy off the table so you can't get the reset.
Right, sure.
I actually did that with Enzo last weekend. Unfortunately, he forgot to roll the Greedo die in, so he got a lot of hate online.
That happens. I've made that error before. So I think indifferent is a nice too, but I don't think we have room for it.
Because I mean, again, we have 3 slots. Yeah. So if I'm, you know, but that's basically what I had. I had Philp, Beguile, and Friends in Low Places, Beguile, and another one I did have. I have Hasty Exit as well, being potential.
So good.
The problem with Hasty Exit is it only removes. It's not a problem that only removes damage, but it does backfire on you sometimes, and that is just a dead card, right, if you get in trouble. But could we make the argument that in this deck, if you fall behind, you're probably in trouble anyway?
Right. Yeah, we should, if we do not have the battlefield every single time, we made an error, or there is a ground battalion on the field, right, or a Rex. That's the only reason why we don't have the battlefield. In fact, we're going to leave dice on the table in order to get the battlefield.
Yeah, but I don't know that this deck can outpace Vader. Vader is really fast. Yeah.
Well, it's a sitwitch, right? I'm going to roll the character out. And then,
yeah, I mean, so I don't know that that's an all-encompassing statement that we should always have the battlefield.
I think we should strive to be ahead of everyone.
Yeah, no argument there.
Yeah. I love Hasty Exit is so good, and you can power action and then give them the battlefield
so
with the next action.
If we drop the Falcon,
okay,
we can add another slot, which gives us 2 2 ofs.
Okay.
But because it brings us back to 4, so we can get 2 2 ofs.
I'm comfortable running Beguile and Friends in Low Places. Like I think our
But what about Hasty?
I think even without Hasty Exit, our removal package is still
okay. So you don't want to know.
We're running 3 hyperspace jumps. Hyperspace jump says remove everybody's dice.
Okay. Well, but in that case, the 2 cost removals may not be. Maybe you want the 0s and not the 2 cost removals for the cost curve, right?
Okay.
I mean, because Yoda's only making you so much money. Because if
me. Well, Han's make me money too.
Right, but what we're talking is at the point where Han's dead.
Okay.
And Yoda's your lone survivor, and he's piloting both his N1s through the Force, right?
Well, if he's the only one alive, and I start with 2 resources, mm-hmm. I want a Beguile in hand so that I can eliminate my opponent's turn. The reason I like Beguile is it's no spot, and I don't have to have anything in the pool to do it. It's a
How are you paying for your jumps, I guess is what I'm saying. Because, well, I mean, if you only have Yoda left, what you want to do is you want to roll in, you want to special into 2 of your Black Suns, and then get the heck out of there.
Right. Yeah, no, I don't know the answer to that.
So
would rather run Beguile and Hasty Exit than Friends in Low Places.
That's actually where I'm going. I say we drop Philp.
Okay.
And run Hasty. And then you want to run 2 Beguiles, or do you want to run an Entangle and a Beguile?
I would rather run Beguile because it
affects... 2 Beguiles?
Yeah, I'd rather run 2 Beguiles.
I think I agree, because if Han is dead, you probably... Well, I mean, obviously you can't spot, but
If we don't run Entangle, that only leaves us with 2 spot cards in the entire deck. And they're spot blue, and Yoda's going to be left anyway. So I think it's brilliant. Our cards are going to be on the line the entire game.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm on board. So, I mean, that's it then. That's it. So 2 Beguile, 2... All right, so just to recap, just going down. So the upgrades are 3x Sun Pistol, 2 Holdouts, 2 Hiddens, 2 Second Chance, 2 Illusions, 2 Force Speeds. Then we have 2 N1 Starfighters, which is really just our vehicle tech.
Correct.
We have 3 jumps. We have 2 pickings, 2 impulsives, 2 overconfidence, which is a spot.
Right.
We have 2 hiddens, 2 beguiles, and 2 hasty exits.
That is a very strong removal package. Like, we're going to be hard. We're going to be hard to get through to, which I think is great. I'm not worried about money at all, because we're going to be able to show a hero card whenever we're going to actually be able to chain from If we want to chain from, we could chain from Yoda special to gain a resource, chain in a Han, show a hero card, which we have a whole grip of, gain a second one.
No, Han is going to make us
a ton
of money.
And do two damage.
Yeah, Han's going to make us a ton of money. There's no argument there, right? So, okay, so I think that's pretty much it. The last question I want to ask before we finalize the list is, would you actually, I would be willing to sacrifice a Force Illusion and throw in the Falcon. And only run one illusion.
Yeah, I hate Force Illusion. I like what it does. I hate the cost that I pay. So I'm all for that because I think we're going to be.
I'm just really. I mean, Vader. Vader hurts.
Sure, Vader hurts.
And get it, but I would be willing to sacrifice an illusion for the Falcon if that's the tech we want to run.
You're the one that's going to be. Do you think, with your hands on the stick here?
The question for you is: do you think Yoda needs the Falcon because he's going, I mean, in game, he's going to have at least two Sun Pistols on him.
And as we've been talking about this, and we've been building our other cards, I almost think that the four costs on the Falcon probably takes it out of the running at this point.
You're not going to jump.
Right. We're already running 3-3 cost upgrades and, 6-3 cost upgrades.
Right. Three cost cards,
right? And then
You're counting the N one, yeah. Five three cost dice,
right? And then three jumps, costs. Yeah. So four
plus
to
two
me,
beguiles. Yeah, it's expensive. Yeah,
I don't think we can run the Falcon. I would probably rather hide behind the illusions, and then I'm not one though that's going to. You're right. Illusion is kind of stupid until you run into a Vader. Right, and then it might save your life. Now it's gonna probably eat 6-7 of your cards, which is a problem.
Well, but making it till turn two is not bad. I mean,
does Han have a discard side?
He does. You're thinking Rebel?
I think it's worth a discussion.
Let's do that instead because I was on Rebel as well, so we could run 1x Rebel. Because they only each have one discard side, right? If this was Gen Cassian or something, you're running two, no problem.
Correct.
But they're not. They only have one discard side apiece. Now, Rebel's not a spot. I don't believe it is. Please.
I don't believe it is.
I'm positive Rebel's not a spot.
It's just a resource. I'm sorry. You have to have a discard side in your pool.
Right.
It happens all the time. Like, I mean, you always, between four dice,
It doesn't happen all the time. The reason it feels like it happens all the time is because it's the side you don't want to see with Yoda. That's why it feels like it doesn't.
Yeah, there's no spot.
Right.
No spot.
So let's do that then. So, all right. So final list, just for the stream. Dick, building is iterative. There's no problem in this. And we're talking through. I like it, right? So for upgrades, we have 12. We have 3 Sun Pistols. We have 2 holdout blasters. We have 2 hidden blasters. We have 2 second chance. We have 1 force illusion. And we have 2 force speeds. That brings us to 12 upgrades. We then have 2 supports, the N1 starfighter times 2, which is now at 14. We then have 3 hyperspace jumps, which takes us to 17. And then we move into our removal control jank package. We have 2 pickings, 2 impulsives, 2 overconfidence, 2 hiddens, that's 8, that takes us to 25. We then have 2 beguiles, 2 hasty exits, and a rebel, that brings us to an even 30. Okay, so I'll put the list up. I will also put a link in the YouTube video to the SW Destiny DB link. We'll build it and post it. And then I will play it this weekend and blame Mike for everything goes wrong.
Can I talk about what we're going to name this deck? I think it's very important.
Oh, yeah. I forgot. That's the best part.
That is the best part.
So, I want to take credit for this.
It's totally your idea. So this pairing will be called forever from this day forward. Trademark. YOLO.
You only live once, baby. YOLO. So YOLO's hitting the scene this weekend in the Portland area. Love it. Hate it. Beat it. Yeah. Lose to it, whatever.
I think a lot of people are going to lose this deck. I have to be quite honest with you. I've played Han. I played against Han in a couple of versions now. One with Kira. One with, I think you ran one with Biggs? Was it you running one?
With no, I ran Hong Kong.
Oh, that's right, with Poe. Yeah. I've played one with Biggs as well, and it was quite devastating.
Yeah, the Han Biggs Falcon.
Yeah,
I actually have played that as well. I think it's a super fun deck. Yeah. The Artificery guys actually kind of took credit for that one.
Yeah.
They called it the Top Gun deck.
Right? Oh,
they
yeah.
had the, yes. the Top Gun. So
excellent.
Shout out to the Artificery guys.
Good job,
I kind of modified it a little bit to fit my own personal, but. Well, it's a super fun deck.
The thing in common with these decks that I've been getting destroyed by it appears Han. To be Han, but his sides are outrageous. I mean, he's got three damage sides.
Yeah, I mean, you're bringing up a fair point. We didn't really discuss why I brought up this character. So I approached Mike last week, and I was like, I really want to build a deck with this character pairing. Let's do this. In case you didn't notice, Yoda's pretty good.
Right.
Everybody kind of forgot about him because Snoke.
Snoke, right? Yeah, right.
But Yoda's really good. Hot take, Yoda's really good. And Han is deceptively good, the right statement?
It's that special. Like, if it was a 2-2-2 or 2-indirect, we'd be like...
2-indirect, yeah, I think that's it, right? If it was a 2-indirect, you'd be like, oh, that's okay.
Right.
You're like, oh, it's 2-indirect and a dollar?
I'll tell you this. If he had two gun sides, a discard, and two resource sides, we'd be all over it, too. Because then he would be a money generator. This is actually both.
That's almost OG Han, except the
right. Yeah. Okay. So I think
actually
this guy,
the OG Han had a 2 disrupt, which is actually a killer.
Was he 18 cost though?
Yeah.
Yeah. So well, power creep
and
right?
10 health.
Yeah, it's funny. So I just think he's seriously good. Like this guy, and he's flexible because in the right deck, you actually can show a hero card and a villain card.
Yeah, if you're playing Kira, but.
Or if you're playing,
we've been playing a lot of. Oh, playing. Right. Well, but you can't play him.
Oh, you can't because there's no. Oh, you can play
at 16.
You could play. You'd have to play Solidarity.
Oh yeah.
Whether that's good, I don't know. But
anyway, we're fishtailing.
Yes.
But so that's the plan. So again, I'll post a list. And we'll see how it goes. So we will not be playing this at Monday Night Dice this week because Mike actually has a special event going on at Monday Night Dice. Why don't you describe
it? Yeah, so Monday night we are having our first of many Jankoffs. A Jankoff, for those of you that don't know, is where we get together and we come up with the craziest deck ideas.
But they're still good.
They're still good. Right? My original Jankoff deck was actually 6 die hero. I'm sure... All of you at home who play with me.
That deck was super frustrating. That deck was super
frustrating. Yeah, so it was 2 dice Ezra, 2 dice Maz, 2 dice Jar Jar. It was all mono yellow. It was really fast, and it would...
Vibro Cutlass.
Yeah, it was super fun, and people were like, what are you running? And then like I would jank off, and then they would be sad. Right? We were done. So there's a couple people that wanted to play something kind of different. Our buddy Cole had brought up a really... I don't want to steal Cole's jank thunder, but I have a feeling it's going to be pretty spicy.
If there's somebody who's going to excel at this format, it's Cole.
Yeah. Right. Fair so enough. Yeah. So we're encouraging everyone to bring like the craziest, and then we're going to vote on who brought the jankiest deck, and the jankiest deck would be one that has either the craziest combo or the weirdest character pairing, and then we are going to give a prize to the person who brings the best one. And then also, we have a monthly drawing, and every vote that you get for your deck gives you a bonus ticket.
Oh, sweet.
As well. So cool. We'll let you know how it goes, but I'm pretty excited for the Jankoff.
Cool. And then I think the last plug we both want to make, and actually that's all, also be playing this deck there this weekend, but our good friends at Bunsen Brewer are having a Goodwill tournament this weekend. So it's actually, they're calling it Destiny Food Wars.
Yeah.
Entry is free-ish. You have to donate 10 cans to the Sandy Community Action Center. Mm-hmm. And then we're doing a Swiss. And those 10 cans also, they're doing something cool. Each can gives you a ticket, and you can use those tickets for either deck building cheats, like bring an off-color card, I think, is one of them.
Yeah.
I think you, for like 25 cans, you can bring an off-color character or something like that. Or an off-faction character.
Yeah.
But no, it sounds like a really good time. Go out there, drink some really good beer.
Some really good beer.
Have some fun.
Yeah, and this is one of those times where we actually get to use our powers for good, and
right.
We should be doing that.
Yep, so I'll definitely be there on Sunday. I believe Amy's planning on going. I don't know if you're planning on going.
I have a full week of events, so
but
I don't
we will be, good. We'll be YOLOing it this weekend out of Bunsen Brewer. So,
yeah.
I think that's it. Again, like I said, I'll post the deck. Do you have anything else you want to add?
Go Commando.
Go Commando.